The title of this video is America Was a Mistake. So the first thing to say and emphasize is that the title is not America is a mistake, but rather America was a mistake. Semantics are important. By that I mean that in a navigation sense, the discovery from a European viewpoint of the Americas wasn't planned. It was an error, it was a mistake. I'll explain. Most people know that in 1492, Christopher Columbus and his crew set sail from Spain, intending to reach the East Indies. The East Indies are the islands and coastal regions of South and Southeast Asia. His main goal was to reach the Spice Islands. The Spice Islands that's the modern day Maluku Islands in Indonesia. He believed that by heading west, the first land that he would find would be the East Indies. But after around 10 weeks at sea, they arrived in the Bahamas, not the East Indies. If you've watched any of my other videos, you'll know that I look at things from a navigation perspective. And I've looked all over the internet, I think, and there are many, many websites explaining that Columbus arrived in the Bahamas in 1492. But I can't find a single website explaining why this happened. Why did he make such a big navigation error? So today I want to explore why Columbus believed that he could get to the East Indies by sailing west across the Atlantic in just a few weeks. Now I have to say here that these are just my opinions, so they may be wrong, but I don't think it was his fault. He'd been taught that the Earth was a certain size and shape. So he was just doing what he'd been trained to do. In those days, well, and now, people are taught to do things and they act in a way that they've been taught to do. I'll give you an example. When I was at school, the teacher told me that if I have two apples and then I get two more apples, I have four apples. So the teacher taught me basic maths, and this lesson still holds true. 2 + 2 = 4. Oh, while we're on this point, Americans, please can you stop calling it math? It's maths, plural. Maths is an abbreviation of mathematics, which is just the collective noun for the fields of calculus and trigonometry and geometry and algebra, etc., etc. So there's more than one field, which is why it's mathematics, and why the abbreviation is also plural, maths. It's easy to follow the chain. The Latin mathematica was changed in Old French to mathématique, and this became the English mathematic, which has a standard plural form of mathematics. Oh, on another point, it's not a sidewalk, it's a pavement. From the Latin pavimentum, meaning a hard surface which has been beaten to make it level. Come on, Americans. It's not difficult. You can do it. What are these? What would you call these? Yes, correct. They're trousers. They're not pants. Trousers comes from the old Gaelic, tribus, and pants comes from pantaloons. So there is a difference. I'll delete all this bit anyway. What was I saying? Oh, yes, Columbus. Why did he believe that he could get from Spain to the East Indies in just a few weeks? As the title of this video says, the discovery of America by the Europeans. I'm not sure that the people who already lived there thought that they need to be discovered. Anyway, it was an error, a mistake. I think that the reason for this mistake lies in the maps that the Europeans had used for centuries. They relied on the works of somebody called Claudius Ptolemaeus. He's better known just as Ptolemy. He was a second century Greco-Roman mathematician and philosopher. And his calculations had been the foundation of European geography for over 1,300 years. In other words, Columbus's error and the discovery of the Americas was based on a miscalculation made over 1,000 years before he was even born. even before Ptolemy, there had been many attempts to calculate the size of the Earth. Around 400 BC, Plato declared that the Earth's circumference was 40,000 miles. And 150 years later, Archimedes estimated it to be 30,000 miles. But the most accurate measurements came from Eratosthenes, who was a Greek librarian working in Alexandria in Egypt in the 3rd century BC. He used a simple but brilliant method to calculate the Earth's circumference. He knew that in a place called Syene, which is modern-day Aswan, the sun shone directly overhead at noon on the summer solstice, so there were no shadows. But in Alexandria, on the north coast, a wooden post in the ground did cast a shadow at noon on the same day. He measured the angle of the shadow and found that it was 7.2 degrees. And since a full circle is 360 degrees, this meant that the distance between the two cities was 1/50th of the Earth's total circumference, because 360 divided by 7.2 is 50. As he knew that the distance between Syene and Alexandria was about 500 miles, he just multiplied 500 miles times 50, and this gave him the circumference of the Earth at 25,000 miles. This is remarkably close to the real value of 24,900. And again, this is just my opinion, so I may be wrong. But I think that the reason that Ptolemy said the Earth was smaller than it really is was due to a simple translation error. Now, Ptolemy wasn't trying to come up with his own new calculations. He was actually trying to revise the works of another Greek called Posidonius. And he used the position of certain stars to calculate the circumference of the Earth, and also Eratosthenes, who used shadows. Both Posidonius and Eratosthenes calculated the Earth's circumference at 25,000 miles, which is only 100 miles out, so it was really good. But then Ptolemy got involved and he got it totally wrong. And the question is, why? You have to remember that international borders 2,000 years ago, they weren't the same as they are today. Ptolemy knew that Eratosthenes was a Greek, and he was born in a part of Greece that is now in Libya in North Africa. At the time, people didn't use miles to measure long distances. They used something called a stadium. The problem was, that there was no internationally agreed length of a stadium. So Ptolemy likely assumed that for his measurements, Eratosthenes, as he was Greek, used a Greek stadium, which is 148 meters. What Ptolemy may not have realized was at the time he made his calculations, Eratosthenes was working in Egypt as the head of the library in Alexandria. And to measure the distance between Alexandria and Syene, he would have used Egyptian workers who would pace out the journey using Egyptian stadium. And these are 157 meters long. You see the difference? And this difference in length, which led Ptolemy to underestimate the Earth's circumference. This is one of the biggest errors in geographical history. If Columbus had relied on maps based on Eratosthenes' calculations, he would have known that he couldn't possibly reach the East Indies in just a few weeks, but he didn't. Most maps during the Renaissance were based on Ptolemy's ideas that the Earth's circumference was only 18,000 miles, around. As a result, many maps show that if you sailed west across the Atlantic, you would soon reach Japan or mainland China or the East Indies. There were some maps that showed an almost correct size of the Earth, and Columbus is known to have studied them. I'm not sure why he didn't. As an example, Pierre de Halys' map. We know Columbus looked at this and examined it. However, yet again, a translation error caused another mistake, Pierre de Ali's map used Arabic miles, which are 1830 meters long. Columbus, however, was more used to Roman miles, which are shorter at 1480 meters. And as a result, when he looked at the map, maybe counting the miles between two points, the distance seemed much shorter than it actually was. And this, in his mind, further reinforced his mistaken belief that the East Indies could be reached in just a few weeks. You know, mind you, Columbus was lucky that the Americas did actually exist, because he and his crew would have died of starvation long before they reached the East Indies. His fleet of three ships sailed 4,400 miles from Spain to the Bahamas in about 10 weeks. So that's an average of 400 divided by 7. So he traveled approximately 63 miles a day. If Ptolemy had been correct and the Earth's circumference really was 18,000 miles, Columbus still wouldn't have made it to the East Indies. You know, he would have had another 2,900 miles left to travel, which at 63 miles a day would have taken him another 6.5 weeks. This means that his entire journey would have lasted 16.5 weeks. But when he left Spain, they only carried provisions for 10 to 12 weeks. So even if the world had been as small as Ptolemy thought, Columbus and his crew would have run out of food and likely starved long before reaching the East Indies. But in reality, the Earth's circumference is just under 25,000 miles. And since he'd already traveled 4,400 miles, to get to the East Indies, if America didn't exist, he would still have had another 9,000 miles left to travel. And at 63 miles a day, that would have taken him approximately 20 weeks, bringing the total journey to 30 weeks. Don't forget, again, they only carried, when they left Spain, 10 to 12 weeks of provisions. So Columbus and his crew would have starved before reaching their destination. So even though Columbus bumped into the Americas by mistake, it was lucky for him and his crew that he did. Nowadays, we wouldn't have the same problem that Columbus had, you know, not knowing the circumference of the Earth. You can get the circumference at any given point because most people have a mobile phone. And with one of these, you can work out what the circumference of the Earth is at your latitude. In other words, wherever you are in the world, wherever you're watching this video, if you started traveling east or west, how far would you have to go? How far would you have to travel before you arrived back at where you started? I'll tell you how to do this. It's quite simple. Open Google Maps on your phone and touch the screen at your location. Your latitude and longitude will appear at the top, and you're only interested in the first number, which is the latitude. You can copy the full number, but for today, let's say it's 5408, okay? Next, open your calculator, and if you have an iPhone, select scientific. If you have an Android, just rotate your phone into landscape mode, and the scientific calculator will appear. Now, to calculate the Earth's circumference at your latitude, on the calculator, press cosine, COS, and type in 5408, and then close the brackets. Multiply this by the average radius of the Earth, which is at 3959, and then multiply that by 2 pi, which is, 62832. And the result you should get will be about 14,900. So if I walked east or west from here, I would arrive back after traveling around 14,590 miles. Of course, this is just an approximation, as the Earth, it isn't a perfect sphere. It's slightly flattened at the poles. And this means that the radius changes depending on your latitude. But in my case, because I'm very approximately halfway between the equator and the polar region, the result is only off by a couple of miles. Let me just go and get a I'll get a pen. So I've got, I'm sure you remember how to do this from your geography lessons at school, but you know, we'll go through it again. We're going to calculate the circumference of the Earth at your location, wherever you're watching this video. So we've got C. Now C is the circumference of the Earth, and it's just going to be 2 pi r, and we're going to use the square root of the whole equation. A is the equatorial radius of the Earth, and B is the polar radius, and theta can be, that can be the, your latitude in degrees. All we need are the squared cosines of the two radii and the squared sines of the same as the numerator, and we're going to square that whole thing. We then divide this by the denominator, which is basically exactly the same, except we don't square the equatorial and the polar radiuses, radii, whatever. But we still square the whole denominator. When I get home, I'll put the formula on your screen, and you'll be able to do this in Excel. Let me just write all this down. So here's the actual here's the actual thing. As I said, when I get home, I'll put that on the screen, and I'll make it a little bit simpler to understand. If only Columbus had used his iPhone to do a similar calculation, he would have realized that the East Indies were much further away than he imagined. And with this knowledge, he might not have even set off, or he might not have set off so confidently. And if that had happened, America wouldn't have been discovered in 1492, and the world would be a very different place. But Columbus did arrive in the America by mistake in 1492, and now you know why. So thanks for watching.